Thank you. Oh. quick. We have but a second. Fill round the cup while you may. For time the churl hath beckon, and we must away, away. Grasp the pleasure that's thine, for oh, not Orpheus' strain, but creates with ours from dying, for charm to life again. Then quick, we have but a second. Fill round while you may, for time the churl hath beckoned, and we must away, away.
Songs. I have a lovely memory of Margaret and Mary telling me how excited they were to have this project coming to fruition. It was maybe 7 years ago, maybe it was longer, I don't remember, but their dear father had this passion in his life to, you know, put these songs to
yeah, action. We knew them well because obviously we were colleagues of these two ladies. They are Mary and Margaret O'Sullivan. They were very prominent as workplace, as accompanists, as repetitors. And,
so,
and yeah, of course, their dad was the initiator of all of this. Yeah.
And that was kind of when he died, was at his death, they brought this project to fruition. And it was a hell of a project, and we were very, very thrilled to hear that there were string violin and cello parts. So Arun and I had the privilege of already recording these. So we're very, very proud to do this. And here we are, how many years later, with now the book out, and we have Sharon, and we have the beautiful...
Yeah, so how did you see to play guitar instead of piano?
No, because Beethoven didn't borrow,
of course,
for guitar, but this music was meant to be played in saloon, and the guitar was the other instrument that was used at the time. So I, also looking at the music of Beethoven in this song, I think that the guitar can do a very nice job. And also suit very well the character for some of this song.
Absolutely, because I think in some of our rehearsing we were kind of talking about the sometimes the clash in a good way between the Irish traditional dance rhythms, but yes, then the elegance of Beethoven's chamber music, and this the guitar fits so well with that, and this kind of frisson, then it gives a really, like, these songs are just so unique, I think, in the music literature, that they're, yes, they should be done. Yeah. Again.
And of course you have a personal connection.
Yes, so just speaking of accompanists and repetiteurs, I heard of this several years ago because Tomas's son, Dennis O'Sullivan, was my repetiteur in Vienna when I studied singing there. So, yeah, lots of threads
so
brought together.
There's
as much of a thread as all the green here. No, it's a real pleasure for me to have them as part of our series, because we always wonder, Virginia, if these CDs that we have painstakingly put together back in the days when they were first recorded would ever lead to actual live performances of these songs. And it's not an easy thing to get together, of course, because we have made several attempts.
That's right, yes. Yeah. So we're very privileged that Sharon, you joined us, and Marco too. Yeah,
as are we to be asked to join us.
And of course, of all years, we had to do it this year.
Yes.
We're Beethoven.
We're Beethoven.
infectious song for an infectious ear.
Yes.
So, I think they also contrast very well with the rest of the music, which is on this bill, this concert. So, the intimacy of these songs is very special, I think. And even though maybe it's not quite the salon atmosphere of, that Beethoven would have maybe ideally envisaged for these songs, but I think they work very well here in the sophisticated sense. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Abscheulicher, wo eilst du hin? Was hast du vor? Was hast du vor im wilden Grimme?
Oh, Thank you.
Thank you.